In this video, I will go over a brief introduction, what is a GNU Octave, getting started including download and install, run arithmetic operations, then wrap up with a summary. GNU Octave is a script-based computer programming language primarily aiming at solving algebraic and differential equations. You don't need to compile your computer code to run, so this is one of the biggest advantages over C or R programming languages. So this makes your programming job very easy. It has numerous built-in functions and there are various plotting capabilities. Also, it allows for developing user-defined functions, so you can develop your own functions. This is a free software and highly compatible with the Matlab. Matlab is a powerful commercial scientific computing software, so you can use a GNU Octave as a free alternative to Matlab. To install GNU Octave, you can go to this link, then you can download set of file. You can find this link in the description section below. Or you can Google it by typing GNU Octave download in the search bar and hit OK. Then click the very top list. In download page, bore into Windows tab and download 64-bit installation file and then save it under download folder by hitting save icon. Then you can start downloading it. If you run 32-bit Windows, download 32-bit installation file instead and install. Once you're done, go to the folder that you saved. Here, I saved it in the download folder and then double-click installation file to install and hit OK with the default setting. If successful, you should be able to see two new icons in the desktop, like a blue ring with the three orange rectangle icons. The difference between these two is a user interface. CLI represents a command line interface, and GUI is a graphic user interface. I prefer to use GUI, and you can double-click to launch Octave. In main GNU Octave window, you have five sub-windows. In the central area, we have a command window. On the left side, there are file browser, workspace, and command history. On the right side, we have a variable editor. You can adjust the window size by changing the borderline between the sub-windows. When you move your mouse point to the border, you can see the vertical bar with two arrow-shaped mouse point, and then it is ready to change the sub-window size. For now, I'm going to focus on the command window. In the top part of the command window, you have software version, copyright, and website information for further reading. This version is 4.4.1. Below, there are two consecutive larger than arrows, which we call it command prompt. It follows a blinking cursor, and it means it is ready to take your input. Let's start with a basic calculation. To calculate 2 plus 3, I'm typing 2 plus sign 3 followed by hitting Enter key. It does not execute until you hit the Enter key. It shows a calculation result, which is 5. In Octave, most recent result is automatically saved in a variable ANS. ANS stands for answer. The most recent result can be shown by typing ANS and hitting Enter key. We can also type date and hit the Enter key. Date is a built-in function to check the today's date. You can see that today's date is 2019, January 17. Again, it is automatically saved in the variable ANS. Remember, we have a numeric number 5 in the ANS previously, but the variable ANS is updated with the new result. You can calculate cosine 0 by typing COS parentheses with 0 in between. You can get 1 as expected. You can type CLC to clear the command window. You can also use home as an alternative. To find detailed information of given built-in function, you can use help followed by the built-in function name. For example, if you want to learn more about cosine function, type help space COS. You can see the functionality and syntax. Below, there is also a list of relevant functions that you may be interested in learning. If you do not know the exact function name and want to search it based on the keyword, you can also use look for as a single word. followed by the keyword of the built-in function. For example, if you want to search all the built-in functions having COS as a keyword, type look for space followed by COS. You can see the entire list. For example, in the top list, it shows ACOS, which is a function to calculate arc cosine. It computes the inverse cosine in radians for each element of x. Octave also supports basic arithmetic operators. In this table, A and B are the variables or numeric numbers, and arithmetic operators can be used between two variables or numbers. For addition, we use a plus sign. For subtraction, minus sign. For multiplication, we use a star sign, which is given in the above numeric number 8 in the keyboard. For exponentiation, we use a caret if you want to calculate a to the power of b. The caret is given in the above numeric number 6 in the keyboard. Alternatively, you can use double star signs. Simply type two star signs. And for division, use slash sign. To calculate 2 minus 3, you can simply type 2 minus sign followed by 3, and you can see minus 1 as a result. To multiply 2 by 3, you can type 2 star 3 to have 6. To calculate 2 multiplied by 3 and add 1, type 2 star 3 plus 1, and you have 7. If you want to calculate 2 multiplied by 3 plus 1 as a whole, type 2 star, open parentheses, 3 plus 1 followed by close parentheses. Then you have 8. This expression means that you add 3 to 1 before you multiply 2. To calculate 2 power of 3, you need to type 2 caret 3 or 2 star signs 3 to have 8. You choose whichever you prefer. To calculate 3 divided by 2 and 3 slash 2, so you have 1.5. In summary, you have learned about a brief introduction to GNU Octave, getting started including download and install, run arithmetic operations. Thanks for watching this video, and please subscribe my channel if you haven't done it yet. Thumbs up if you enjoyed. Please feel free to share your thoughts in the comment section below. See you next time.